This is Andrew with a new episode of Madman Review. Today we want to take a look at the pistol caliber carbines, or short, PCCs. In fact, we'll focus on their 9mm variants. Why? 9mm is one of the most common and most affordable pistol rounds out there, and it comes in many flavors. This makes it easy to get it cheap in bulk for training, as well as the right load for self or home defense. This leads, of course, right to the next question. Why a pistol caliber carbine at all? Looking at them, you might ask yourself if the longer barrel does add enough performance to warrant the expenses to buy, weight to carry, and bulk to handle. Thinking about it, there come quite a few answers in mind. First, yes, the longer barrel of the carbine does add a couple of hundred feet per second to the speed of the bullet. That does result in greater range. It also makes the trajectory of the bullet flatter, so that's easier to hit something. Furthermore, it does help with penetration and increases the foot-pounds dumped into the target. Second, it does make it easier to aim and hit all in all, not only through the trajectory of the bullet. With a pistol, you have only one point of contact, that's the pistol grip. With a carbine, you get three, the shoulder, the pistol grip, and the handguard. Also, the longer sight radius is a great help. Third, and most importantly, you end up with the same ammo for both your pistol and your carbine. This allows you to carry only one caliber and use it as it's needed. Fourth, there are a few added advantages. Pistol caliber carbines are not too heavy, not too bulky, and they do not come with the kind of soldier and warlike impression rifles bring to the table. And there's the problem of over-penetration when you use it to defend your home. When a rifle round might sail through the intruder, the wall behind it, the wall of your neighbor's house, and subsequently, your neighbor himself, the pistol round would be stopped either by the intruder's body or the exterior wall. All these reasons led to the pistol caliber carbines being used, or at least envisioned, as a patrol gun for law enforcement officers in rural areas. Nowadays, they have their fan base for their use in home and self-defense, as well as a great toy for the range. Some even ponder their use as a bugaloo gun, a gun to roam the lands after an apocalypse. However, one does not need to look that far to see the advantages of a PCC. When you have made up your mind to buy a PCC, you might, of course, want to do so without breaking your bank. What sense does it make to spend thousands of dollars on a PCC if you could get a high-performance rifle for that kind of money? Going budget means to look at guns below or close to a threshold of around $500. Let's see what you can find for that kind of money. As always, the links to the products discussed here are in the description. Kel-Tec Sub 2000 Gen 2. This is not only a nice little gun, it also adds more to the already mentioned advantage of a PCC. The Kel-Tec Sub 2000 Gen 2 can be completely folded and thereby its length practically cut in half. That makes it so much easier to transport and, if necessary, to conceal it. It does not end here. This gun does use 9mm Glock magazines, so getting a new mag is really no headache. Also, there are various accepting Smith & Wesson, Beretta, or SIG mags as well. The Sub 2000 is praised for its reliability and it's very accurate. And then there is the weight of only 4.25 pounds when it's unloaded. There's practically nothing not to like about it. Add to this the price of below $500, and you have all you've been looking for. High Point 995TS. Looking at the High Point 995TS, you might see the resemblance with the Sub 2000, but do not let yourself be fooled. It is a different gun, and it comes with its very own significant advantage. No, it's not the ability to be folded, it's the price. You can find it for far less than $300. That itself is a very compelling argument for this gun. Okay, with such a price tag, one is tempted to doubt the performance. However, the 995TS does shoot straight and hit what you're aiming at. Also, it's very reliable with its simple blowback system. Granted, the weight of 6.25 pounds might pull you down a little bit, but it does lighten the felt recoil. With a 10 or 20 round magazine, you will have no problem to hit a target at 100 yards dead center. However, given the low recoil, you might be tempted to pump too many rounds in too fast, a succession into your target. This means you have to keep your trigger finger under control. Ruger PC Carbine. Here is a pistol caliber carbine that is almost impossible to avoid. This one comes from Ruger and has an excellent reputation. It's super portable, reliable, accurate, and can use Glock mags, for which you have to use an adapter, but that does come with the carbine. The trigger on this gun is outstanding, the barrel is prepared to accept a suppressor. Also, you can customize this carbine to your personal liking. And last but not least, it comes at a very competitive price. Depending on the time and shortage encountered these days, you get it for a little over $500. However, this might come down once the situation on the market is more stable. Palmetto State Armory 9mm PX9. Here comes the option for all those who just want everything to look like an AR-15. It brings you the look of this rifle and it takes Glock mags. This way, satisfies both kinds of fanboys. For this, it does not even cost much more than $500. The advantage of the PX9 is simple. If you can use an AR-15, you can use a PX9. If you have Glock mags, you can load the PX9. If you have 9mm, you can feed the PX9. All this comes in a reliable package with the necessary accuracy. TNW Firearms Aero Survival Rifle. Here comes a gun with ifs and whens, but also with advantages. If you're willing to shell out a little bit more than just $500, and when you need to defend yourself in a survival situation, then this gun is for you. If you want to buy it secondhand, be careful. As when it was introduced, there was quite some problems with it. It had a very high rate of failure to feed or eject, causing a lot of stoppages. The problems are supposed to be mitigated by now, so either opt for a new rifle or one that is not so old. Okay, so after the ifs and whens, what do you get from this rifle? First, it's a survival rifle. You can easily take it apart and transport it, that way significantly reducing its length and enhancing its concealability. Also, looking from every angle, there's no way to call it heavy. It accepts Glock mags, and you can have it in a lot of different calibers. Those include 40 Smith & Wesson, 45 ACP, 10mm, 357 SIG. Heck, you can even get it as a set with all the bells and whistles. Need to swap it from one caliber to the next. Also, you have a lot of options to customize it. You can have it eject to the left or right. It has a rail on top where you can attach various scopes, red dots, and such. You can have a rail in front of the mag well and attach a bipod, to name just a few. Thanks to the ability to choose the side of the ejection, you can even mount a basket to catch the spent cartridges. If you reload, that means you do not have to search for them on the ground. These are my picks for the best budget 9mm pistol caliber carbines. If you have something to add to this list, put it into the comments. Have fun, and see you next time.